a test of the CCD-TRV32 Video8 camcorder by Sony. The battery came with is dead and I don't have a charger for it. It's supposed to be a 6-volt 1700 milliamp hour NiCad. Instead I'm just using clip leads to a 7.2 volt 21.6 watt hour, I don't know how that converts to a milliamp hour, Sony Info Lithium battery, even though this does not take advantage of the Info Lithium system to show you the battery life, it just gives you a little gauge on the screen, which goes from full to empty, it doesn't give you a minute's readout, it's too old for that. Another thrift store find here is this Toshiba Satellite 105CS laptop, similar to my Satellite Pro 410CS, except it's only a Pentium 75. Display is only 640 by 480 instead of 800 by 600. Also passive matrix, and it only has a floppy drive. You cannot change this out for a CD-ROM drive, and there's no sound card, just a beeper. Otherwise, the same chassis, pretty much. PC MCI slots there. Also, no fan, just cooling vents. And it was owned by Jeff Kameko. If I can get this open again. Hang on. Okay, this is standard 8, not high 8, so you may not be able to read this. So I'll try to get close to it. Original installation of Windows 98. Original owner has your information there. Just cleaned out some of the junk, but it's still loaded with programs. You can see Netscape, Earthlink, games, Microsoft Office, some kind of Casio camera program. You go to programs, you can see a long list of programs. You have to even scroll it to get to the whole thing. I've never seen Windows 98 with so many programs on it. And the latest documents I could find are from 1999. So it may not have been used since then. But it's working, although slowly. See, I think I sorted this by date. Let's see, sorted by date. There are five, actually, June 5th, 99 is the last document saved in this, my documents. So, it's working. Didn't come with battery or anything, but it's working. And actually has a 4 gig hard drive. Upgraded from the original 520 meg hard drive, so that's a nice upgrade. And it's also maxed out with 40 megs of RAM. So that's my thrift store find of the laptop, bought for $9.99. Also this Sony Video 8 camcorder, which is working off of this battery here. Let me try 16x9 mode. Okay, this is so-called cinema 16x9 mode, which just cuts off the top and bottom of the image. And I'll show you the other mode. Okay, this is 16x9 full mode, which is actually anamorphic 16x9, which shows the image vertically stretched or horizontally squished on the LCD, but when you play it back on a widescreen TV, it fits the 16x9 aspect ratio. So we'll see how that comes out. May not have enough resolution to take advantage of the 16x9. So we'll see how this comes out. My thrift store camcorder has steady shot. Well, actually, it's not going to work in this mode, but has steady shot, but no night shot because that wasn't invented yet. Wasn't invented until 98, and this camcorder is from 97. Okay, one last thing I'm going to try is the external microphone jack. Now, even though this is only mono, it does have an external microphone jack with plug-in power, so I'll try this mono. It has a stereo jack on it, but it's only mono GE microphone. Okay, we are now recording using the GE microphone, which does a very good job usually. And in this case, it swivels. Right now it's facing forwards. Right now it's facing towards the right side. And unplugged. I felt kind of loose, so I hope it worked. So let's do, I think there's only a regular fader. Yeah, it can only fade to black, it doesn't give you anything else, so we will now fade to black this test of the Sony Video 8 camcorder. Bye bye.